So the first three spheres in the Tree of Life, the divine will, wisdom, and understanding. Okay? That means that everything that happens in your life is willed by God. It's deliberate. And it's exactly what you need based on perfect understanding and perfect wisdom. Right? Now, what is the purpose of this, of everything that happens to you? It's these next three spheres. This represents the spiritual self, your true self. Spheres 4, 5, and 6 represent the true spiritual being you are. Not the personality, but your true spiritual being that lives forever. So sphere 4 represents the birth of the true self. And that birth of the true self is determined by you feeling happy. If you're not feeling happy, that's not your true self coming through. That's your false self. Happy, loving toward yourself and others, right? There's no sense of guilt or recrimination. Happy, loving, kind toward yourself and others. Feeling a sense of total unlimited abundance, total unlimited freedom. Basically feeling that you live a life of grace, that everything is taken care of for you, that there's nothing you have to worry or concern yourself about. When you're coming from those energies, that's your true self. Now, when you come from those energies, there are certain limits you have to impose on how you behave. That's Gevurah. There are certain times when someone can ask you to do something or expect something from you, but you're starting to feel you're slipping into a dark space. That's where you use Gevurah to say, no, I will not do that. And then if I'm feeling any sense of guilt or self-recrimination about it, any sense of negativity about it, I go through the method or do some purification process to get free. When I follow this balance of being true to myself and setting appropriate boundaries so that I can stay in this positive state, that gives birth to beauty. That's the essence of who you really are. That's the Christ being, the divine being. That's your guidance in all things. You'll be creating beauty in every situation. See, if you just come from just kindness and say yes, 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 you're going to create ugliness. You're going to destroy yourself and others. If you just say no, 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 you're going to create ugliness. But when you have the perfect balance where you're pure of any internal negativity, you're going to be creating beauty. Like you're creating beauty where you live right now. You created beauty in your apartment. You're going to create beauty in your relationship with everybody in your life. It's going to be a beautiful creation, even though some people may demand something else. For you, it's going to be totally beautiful. It's going to be beautiful outcomes. That's victory. When you're creating beauty in every situation, that's the victory of your true self. That means you've ascended in mastery relative to the challenges that God gave you. And as you ascend in that mastery, you experience the true beauty, the true perfection. You just glow with perfection. You see the world as perfect. And this is all, so this is the personality. These three spheres, victory, honor, and foundation, that's the personality level. The personality level has to be a clear vehicle through which these higher forces flow through, and that's how you manifest the kingdom of heaven on earth. Okay, so when you look at this image, right, you're looking at sphere one, is divine will, wisdom, and understanding governs everything that happens in your life. You want to always work on coming from the true self, which is loving kindness, joy, abundance, and grace. You establish the boundaries necessary for this to be sustained, and that's how you produce beauty in every situation. That's the victory of life. That's what you're here to accomplish, to be a channel for beauty in every situation. Then you experience the splendor and the glory, because you see you no longer run by dark emotions and negativities and negative thoughts. Beauty guides your thoughts. Beauty guides your emotions and desires. Beauty guides your thoughts. Beauty purifies your subconscious. And then this is the eternal foundation, so that this process goes on forever until you have finally mastered every aspect of the earth plane, right? And each time you reincarnate from the level you left off at last lifetime. So you always build upon the victories of the past in your spiritual development. That's what the Tree of Life represents. So when you look at it as a whole, this is the basic structure of God, the basic matrix of the universe that gives birth to the visible universe, perfectly balanced, right? Guided by divine will. The aim is always beauty, to manifest the kingdom of heaven on earth. So when you look at this, you try to feel totally balanced, physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, because that's what this represents, and it tunes you into the path of beauty.